Howdy, folks, and welcome back once more. Let's play Legends of Amberland today. We're killing dogs, and I believe B-Cat also said that the bears look like wampas, and once he mentioned that, I cannot unsee it. So we're also going to be killing some of those. Tentatively, we'll see. Assuming we don't get, you know, eaten alive, which... At this stage, I'm feeling pretty comfortable. So I'm not too particularly worried. It is nice. We first started at even this area, and we were having to be very careful picking our fights with these little shitheads. Now, nothing. And of course, as soon as I start recording, my phone goes off. Because what else is gonna... Ela knows how it goes. I mean, back when he used to Let's Play. But inevitably, as soon as he would start a video, the cell phone would go off, and then he'd go off on a rant, just like I'm doing right now. Just carrying the torch. Okay, so we've got more of the bears over there. I want to clear overland here. I've mentioned that I wish that there were more critter layers on the map, kind of like you'd see in the earlier Might and Magic games where you'd burn them down or whatever and gain XP. And part of the reason for that is just having them around gave you a reason to poke around on the map, because as it is right now, basically everything that's interesting is highlighted, you know, even chests. So I really don't have a reason, you know, this little chunk of terrain over here looks interesting. Looks like there should be something here. There isn't. And that kind of sucks a little bit, but I'm maybe just looking for something to complain about there though. All right, Ice Queen's bear. I think these things have AoE, don't they? I guess it doesn't matter, they hit really fucking hard. Holy shit. We're okay. We got this. We gotta go back and fight that dragon again. Instruction in front of you is the abandoned palace of the Ice Queen. Many, many years ago, some heroes defeated the queen. Her spell perished and I was set free. Since then, I sit here and keep watch. So no young, gullible girl enters the premise of the palace in order to try to become the new Ice Queen. I've dedicated my life to it. Death to the Ice Queen. Olaf, is that a Frozen reference? I've not actually seen Frozen, but I'm pretty sure that the snowman is called Olaf, isn't he? I see you, video game. I see what you're doing. I respect it, but I also see it. All right, let's go heal up. We have money. I don't remember. Was there something I wanted to buy here? We got the cheese. We have levels? We have some levels, but I'll wait for the wizards and we can just do everybody all at once. I don't think so. I guess not. We still have no craftsman present. Ring of Mind Fortress. This still reminds me of... Dark Sun, specifically Mind Fortress. There's a psionic power. I'm pretty sure it's called Mind Fortress. Maybe. I may be mixing it with, there's one I think called like Tower of Iron Will. I may be mixing those up. All right, so we've got Ice Queen up here. It's obviously one of the corners of the map. You can see in the upper left there. So that's gonna be where one of the slags is. There's also going to be one down here. Probably through the Mithril Mine, if I had to guess. Oh, that's right. We needed 10,000. We needed 10,000 for the sailing, right? Was it you? No, you were a trainer. Where was the dude that taught us sailing at? Hell. Is this all just dwarves? That's a guard. Was he in town? This wasn't him. No. This is Cheese Guy. That's the mayor. Oh, no. Oh, I'm never gonna remember where that dude is. Wait. I don't have to remember, because we talked to him, didn't we? Deermore Inn A3. So he totally is in this town. He's just in the fucking inn hiding. Yes. expert navigation. Hi-ho distraction. Where's my boat? Like my actual boat. Did I leave it back over here? No. Then did I leave it here? I did. Alright, seas. No longer will you burden me with your bullshit. Yeah, look at that. We're cross-continental now. Fuck the police. Okay. Try fighting this dragon again. Somebody in the comments mentioned that I should have, the last time that we fought him, I should have used, recovery on gold leaf. And I, of course, naturally completely forgot because I'm a freaking idiot. Okay. Just attack. Devon! I wish you had anything resembling offensive magic. Anything. Alright, and then it's gonna be Call of Blizzards. Call of Blizzards. Oh, you missed! Get wrecked, son! Okay, first fatality. Begin the restoration. Okay, multiple fatalities, but that's okay. I mean, not really, but... let's... Mass power heal and restoration. Okay, fine, fine. Mass power heal, restoration. All right, there's the fire. That's the one I was worried about. Okay, recovery. I wish Devon could cast mass power heal. That would be so handy. Oh, we've got this. Gold leaf, kill it. No, oh, killed by the cleric. That's what you get. We got a Chivo, slayed a dragon. Only 2,700 experience. I feel as though these rewards are a bit lacking considering how nasty that thing is. That thing was worth less than 3 foxes, lupuses, whatever the fuck's worth of experience points. All right, what's in the cave? Info. Lair of a fearsome red dragon. Well, we killed it. I'm gonna be pissed if there's another one in here. No, instead we just get loot. As it should be. Crest of Autumn. Blade of Tier 1? Ring of Grand Sages. Okay, what's that? Knowledge 4. No, I don't really actually care. And then the Crest of Autumn is, I think, just resistances, right? Yeah, lightning, and then the Blade of Heroes. I think that's actually what, yeah, that's what Chunk's using. Crest of Winter, Heavy White Helm, Heavy Yellow Helm of Displacement, and Ice Armor of Wisdom. This is actually really good. Purely for the displacement. If it's gonna go on to anybody, it's gonna go on to Chunk. Lose some armor, take a 1/3 miss chance. Absolutely worth it. I would give it to Brynhilda, but she only has the one heroism item. Chunk is getting by on his armor and his sword. I mean, I guess I could give Brynhilda a Blade of Heroes, but I don't want to sacrifice her damage. Alright, so the treasure chests in here. Oh, I was gonna say. Okay, there's a big one. I was gonna say, the treasure chests in here were actually kind of disappointing. This better have something tier 3 in it. Black plate armor, a second set. Oh, damn. All right. Heavy hammer and heavy forge armor. Heavy hammer is terrible. Heavy forge armor, insulated. Immune to environmental damage from frost and lava. That's actually not bad. But the black plate. Oh, the black plate. Oh, she can't carry it. Fuck. Chunk can. Chunk actually... Oh, no, he can't. Shit. Oh, no. Encumbrance. How come she is encumbered? Oh, here. Let me sleep so I can see my actual encumbrance. There we go. I was gonna say, I was pretty sure she'd be able to equip that. So Chunk, I think, actually can wear the black plate. Can't he? Yeah. Oh, damn. All right, that is going to do wonders for his survivability. The resistances are great on that. Brynhilda's kind of lacking, but what are you gonna do? All right, well, there's our first dragon down. That's always exciting. Let's zip over to town here really quick. I just want to vendor stuff. Oh, and I suppose we can level. Everybody's ready to ding. Stat points? No. All right. One shop. That's what we want. Oh my god. I can't griffin in town. I shouldn't be bitching, but I'm bitching. We do have these two blue potions, which is knowledge. One for you, one for you. I feel as though clerics benefit from knowledge far less than the arcanes do. Okay. I might actually give this chainmail to Brunhilda. Hers has protection on it. See, I would be giving her this to give her a secondary source of heroism to eventually swap her helm out for something. Here, I'll give her the better helm of brave heroes. I don't know why I had her using a tier 2 one. One point of armor. No, I don't think I'm going to. All right, we're just gonna vendor the rest of our regular gear. I'm gonna sell jewelry and stuff that gives us resistances to status effects like poison and stuff, because that doesn't seem too particularly useful. They're, at this point, reasonable enough to cure. We are, of course, going to be holding on to levitation and stuff. All right. And that can go, and that can go. There we go. Much, much pared down our bloated inventory. Okay, what's wrong with you? You are overburdened, the hell you say, by a point? How about dump the amethyst necklace for boots of levitation? There, I think everybody in the front row, except for Swell, has some form of carrying capacity, but Swell doesn't need it because he's a knight and can just carry the fucking world, apparently. Let's see, is there anything I have that I could give him that is actually worth anything? How are his resistances? Fire and lightning. Do I have anything that's fire and lightning? I do not. I have cold and lightning. I checked the shop, but there's nothing there, so he's just going to go without for the time being. Where was I? I know I could throw, like, a stopgap item there. But damn it! If I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it right, and it probably triggers somebody in the comments, and that makes me laugh. So, yeah. Anything up here? Oh, what do we have here? Black Dragon's Lair. Nope. Okay. That's a sometimes adventure for not right now. Yeah, this I think is Ogreburg over here, isn't it? Yeah. How are you? Are you guys like those, like, 800 hit point? Oh my god, they're just little babies now. Look at them. That's adorable. Let's kick the shit out of them. I remember when you guys were scary. Now everybody's like death magic and down they go. I've been lax on mowing the map, I realize. I have not been properly stepping in every square. I will excuse not mapping the ocean because that's just ridiculous. These overland areas, I have no excuse. I need to go back. We need to go up into the frozen area here and just get all this mapped. So who are you? Ogres came here around 10 years ago and erected their citadel. Most people fled, but I stayed, and you know what? Those ogres do not pester anyone. I can live peacefully and they ignore me. It's very suspicious behavior for ogres, if you ask me. Seems as if they're content just protecting the mountain pass. That's not how ogres behave, at least not by their own will. Good to know. Alright. I'm gonna grab my boat. I'm gonna zip across here really quick. I'm gonna quick save because I'm a coward. I wanted to do something and I can't remember what it was. Oh, okay, I remember what I wanted to do. I wanna clear over here. I just wanna clear areas. I know it probably feels like I'm being super erratic in how I'm running around. I promise that there is method to my madness. I want to just clear off kind of easily explored areas. Ooh. We'll leave that for now. I want to clear off these areas that are kind of, I don't want to say underleveled for us, but that I can chew through really easily before we start working on the more nasty stuff. It's coming, I promise. Yeah, we're just kind of clearing the map out here a little bit. Okay, because yeah, I wanted to know if there was a secondary connection up to this, which I assume that the slag is in here in the Ice Queen's castle, but I don't know what's going to be in the rest of this area. I'd be curious to find out. I am living in the small valley with a volcano. It's a nice warm place. I'm hunting to supplement our frugal food supplies and to get furs for trade. I'm the pillar of our export sector, you know. Wait, I just got an idea. Why don't you find me a flower? I wanted to give one to my wife, but it's so hard to find any in this icy wasteland. I'll give you something interesting in return. Flower for the hunter. There's a flower shop somewhere in the road. Oh, I think I remember that. Yeah, the woman, she said she wouldn't sell us a flower unless we needed it for something. But we'll deal with that momentarily. So this is like, instead of an oasis in a desert, this is like a little volcanic area in a frozen hellscape. My husband is a hunter and he spends half his time in the tent in the wild. I hope he's not cold. Welcome to our hidden valley. The lava keeps this area warm in the midst of the frozen ice. We lead a simple life with the basic necessities, and anything we lack, we trade by selling furs. Nothing to complain about, really. Alright, so it's just a tiny little area. Alright, where was Flower Shop? I do distinctly remember it, but I'll be asked if I know where it is. No, this is the mayor, right? Yeah, the lazy-ass mayor of this podunk little burg. She in Riverfell, maybe? This town is crazy! Nothing else to sell. Valid reason to acquire one of my precious followers. Would you like to purchase it? Proceed with the transaction. Yes, all of my money. Here you go, one certified flower from a gardenia shop. Be sure to handle it with care. One of our skilled wizards has cast a spell to ensure it lasts longer and can endure any hardships during travel. Nevertheless, please, please handle it with care. Gained flower. Flower. Certified highest quality flower from gardenia shop. Oh my god. All right, and then we'll just zip out here. Hey, buddy. What a lovely flower. I'm sure my life will love it. Here, take this key I found. I have no idea what it opens, but it looks important. I mean, there's no sign of any rust on it, even though it was laying in the snow for years. I'm sure it's magical or something. 5,000 XP is nice, and a silver frost key. Used in the abandoned Ice Queen's palace. I suppose that's the game telling me that's where I should be going next, but of course I'm going to wholly ignore that. And we are instead going to sail to the far south, because I'm curious about what lies down here. Beyond the deep waters. Mostly just down in this little nook down here, and then yes, we'll probably be going over to... Hello, bees! I accidentally stumbled into you! That's a lot of bees! Power heal. Fire. And fire. There's a lot of bees. Holy crap. Holy good god. Alright, I mean, I guess we can try this. Very carefully. Very, very carefully. They seem manageable for now. Okay. They're good XP. And they seem reasonable enough to heal through. Mostly. Okay, maybe not. Why was that such a shitty heal? My petulance is rising. would be, I say it would be interesting if in addition to dealing damage over time, because like realistically it's not doing a ton of damage, poison is what I'm talking about right now without having mentioned it. If in addition to dealing, you know, chip damage to you, basically it reduced the amount you received in heals, that would make it kind of interesting, something you would have to consider. I think Devon would have been better as an elf, purely because he would have access to Elven Touch, which would give him a poison cure, which would be something useful to do with his spell points outside of occasionally buffing our party's strength score. Okay, let's go back. Let's have a nap. Let's go to the back. Quick save for cowardice. Fucking dick wasps. Wasps are assholes. Anybody that says otherwise is a sympathizer and should be taken out and dealt with. There's gotta be, I bet you this cave is a nest, isn't it? It's got a hive over here. Is that what this is gonna be? We have so many dungeons. I love it. I'm excited. We have so many dungeons to fuck around in. It's great. I have to say, I really liked the first Legends of Amberland, and I definitely like this one more. Is it a nest? No, just a small cave. Yet another nameless small cave. There's no way there's not bullshit in here. Oh. Thanks for your experience, but oh, I see that. All right, there's a secret there. Yeah, you found me. I came here to search for some wood and end up smashing a nest with my hatchet. I didn't expect wasps to be that big and lethal. I quickly ran away, hiding in this cave, and began to lose hope that anyone would find me. Anyway, I'm certain the mayor of Deermoor will express gratitude for your rescue, so be sure to pay him a visit. By the way, it appears some kind of old abandoned pirate hideout, so take a look around. I'm sure they hid a treasure somewhere around here. Yeah, they did. Magic armor and a ring of wizards. Is it worth anything? That armor is actually not bad, but it is way too heavy. And the ring of wizards is just another wizardry item, which is actually an upgrade for Rove. Look at that. I do also like that even this late in the game, we're still getting upgrades to our gear pretty regularly. Some other RPGs could take a hint from that. Okay, let's go pass through the mayor. My hope is he's gonna give me a bunch of money. Take this gold, 5,000. That's not as much as I was hoping for, but I will take it. Man, this is a good staff. Arcane 50. I think they're using like 20. No, no, he's got 50. All right, never mind. Fuck that staff. It's useless to me. Displacement on a helm. That's pretty good. Okay, nothing else too insane. A tier 3 ring of wizards. I would almost get this because it's fairly inexpensive, but one extra willpower doesn't really mean too much. But I want to see. I wish Goldleaf had heroism on something that wasn't her damn helmet. Let's see. She has armor 14. Can she get anything else? No, not really. I mean, I could get her some heavy chainmail with resistances on it, but I would rather have, like, fire. Because, yeah, I would love to get her something with displacement. That would, I think, do a lot to shore up her survivability. But I'm not getting rid of heroism. It is just too good. I wish I had, like, a ring or something with heroism for swell. But not really seeing anything like that. Alas, here's the pawn shop. Get rid of some of the junk we picked up. I'm gonna get rid of these lower tier cloaks of the salamander, I think. And there we go. I'm going to give Swell this ring of fire resistance. His resistances are so freaking crazy. I love it. All right, where was my boat? Where did I leave my ship? Is like right here, right? Yes. Okay. All right, we'll come down here and see what's in this corner. And then it's looking like it's gonna be Ice Palace time. I need to get food too. I need to remember to buy food. And what do we have here? Irrigan. Ah, mail from my... Oh, we found that hermit we were looking for. How nice of you to deliver the mail for me. Take this vial as a reward. If you would be so kind, deliver this letter to my colleague living somewhere to the north. And a letter to Oregon. Alright. Emerald necklace, tier 2. Sorcery and poison resistance. Don't really care. Oregon. Is that up here? You can't summon a griffin if you're standing on a tree! I'm not gonna question it. Video game logic, right? Oh no, it's not on a tree, it's in my... I'm in a desert. Fine, we'll sail, game. Good lord, actually, speaking's a witch. I believe someone here owes me money. Finally, some heroes. Yeah, that's what I say. I trust you weren't anticipating half the kingdom and the hand of the princess. I never approved such a reward, so whoever conveyed that to you is spreading falsehoods. I'm happy with 10,000 experience points and 3,000 gold for kicking the shit out of that dragon, though. Okay. It might be this guy right here. This is kind of reminding me of, like, the draw cab monks. No, this is Osrix. All right. If I were an Oregon, where would I be? I don't really know. And quite honestly, for vials, I don't quite care. So we're just gonna head to the north. We'll stumble upon him probably at some point. I'm not too worried. The quest log is actually quite good in this, so. There's gotta be a Balrog or something down there. Okay, before I do this, I need to hit an inn. Because I wanna sleep, and I wanna buy food, and I wanna zip our asses up here. It's a lot of bears. Ooh, and a mega bear. Hell yeah, we're gonna kick the shit out of all of those before we go in here. But I think for now, I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode. So as usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope y'all had a good time, and I will see you all next time. We're probably gonna do another one of these slag things. Maybe two, but probably just the one. Until then! Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, feed the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching.